Okay, so we're told that over the course of any year, as many as 17,000 persons will be living on the streets somewhere in New Mexico, and more than 6,000 people will be homeless at some point right here in Albuquerque. The numbers are worse for New Mexico children. At last count, 9,000 children had no place to go, and Albuquerque Mayor Richard Berry is tackling homelessness head-on as he has launched Albuquerque Heading Home in an effort to address chronic homelessness in our city. Mayor Berry, good to have you.
Good morning. How are you?
I'm great. I'm so happy you're here. I've been wanting you to come to the
show. Thanks for having me on. I love the show.
I'm so glad.
And this is great to be on to talk about really a serious issue in our city.
It really is, and we can't discard these staggering statistics that are really mind-blowing. I mean, you actually have walked the streets, and so you've reached out personally to the homeless. And so what I want to talk about is really what's the most poignant moment for you during those experiences?
Well, Nikki, I think there were several. Going out and doing the survey process and talking to people who've been chronically homeless, and that's really what Albuquerque Heading Home is about. It's about the chronically homeless.
Yeah.
And I can tell you a little bit about that if you want to know the differences.
Sure.
But one of the things that happened last year was when we started the survey process, it was during that cold snap that we had. Remember when the gas was out throughout New Mexico?
My heating bill went.
we had sub-zero temperatures around the city of Albuquerque. One evening we were out and it was so cold you could barely stand to be out, even with a ski jacket on and long johns and all those things.
Sure.
And we came across an elderly woman at a bus stop.
Okay.
And when the people from the coast team were trying to help her into the van to get her some shelter, she was so cold that she was literally almost frozen in the seated position.
Gosh.
And it's just really heart-wrenching when you see these people who, these aren't panhandlers we're talking about. Yeah. These aren't people that are out standing on the street corners during the day and getting their vehicle and going home.
Right.
These are people
who
have been on the street, some of them for 30, 40 years.
My gosh.
And some of them
have
end-stage liver disease, end-stage renal, they have renal failure, they've got some really serious health issues, some have mental health issues. And so the chronically homeless are this part of the homeless population that really we think and needed help at a really high level.
Absolutely, and therefore you have created Albuquerque Heading Home. So tell us about that.
Well, I was on an airplane coming back from Los Angeles one time and I was reading an article and it talked about a project they had in Los Angeles where they surveyed the 50 most chronically homeless people in the city of Los Angeles and what the cost to the community was and what the cost from a human standpoint was.
Okay.
And not only were the outcomes for these individuals extremely negative, but from a health standpoint and from a mortality standpoint, but the expense to the community was tremendous. And I think it was almost $10 million for 50 individuals, because these are individuals that end up in emergency rooms, they end up with hospital stays, because they're out in exposure situations and those kinds of things, and they've got some health issues. And so what I wanted to do for the city of Albuquerque was come up with a meaningful program. And it took us about a year to really come up with what, with Albuquerque Heading Home, that we thought was really this idea of the smart way to do the right thing.
Okay.
And to really improve income or improve outcomes for the individuals that are involved and also improve the cost to the community.
So how does it all work? What is the focus?
Well, we went out last year. We'll go out again and do it this year.
Okay.
And we were on a quest to identify the 75 most vulnerable homeless people in the city of Albuquerque.
Okay.
And so we did that, and we surveyed several hundred people. We came up with 75 people who really had the most severe health issues, that had been on the streets the longest, that really had the greatest risk of dying on the streets, quite frankly.
Okay, and so that's how you choose the 75?
That's how you choose the 75.
Okay.
And then we've also taken into consideration what the cost to the community is of taking care of these folks while they're on the streets, and we're comparing that with the cost of giving them a place to live.
Okay.
So this is a housing first model, and what it does is it takes the chronically homeless and it puts them into housing that we subsidize.
Okay.
It then surrounds them with support services so that not only do they have a better outcome for them, whether it's a health outcome or just the fact that they're off the streets.
Right, right.
But it also keeps them out of the emergency rooms. It keeps our police and fire departments from having to respond to situations that are critical on the streets. And that's what we're talking about, the smart way to do the right thing. It's great for the outcome for the individuals.
Right.
And it also saves us a lot of money as a community.
Yeah, it really does. It works in both ways. So everybody benefits from it. And it is a multi-step program. And it's incorporating really hundreds of volunteers, hundreds of businesses, community nonprofit organizations.
Absolutely.
I mean, so many people are involved. So when you look at those steps, could you kind of give us, can you kind of draw it out for us how the steps work?
Sure. We first of all, if you look at one of the individuals that's currently in housing, what we do is we went out and did the survey. We identified these individuals.
Okay.
Then our Family and Community Services Department, and also there's a gentleman named Dennis Plummer from Housing Coalition that will come in, and they will work with these individuals to get them into housing.
Okay.
So then we just received, I think today yesterday we announced that we had got $1.5 million grant from the federal government.
Oh, that's wonderful.
For Albuquerque Heading Home to help us pay the cost of this housing for these individuals.
That's great.
It's a long process. One of the things that we found in this first year, and we knew we would run up against barriers and hurdles. And one of the things we found out was the paperwork to get this done was almost insurmountable for people. So we've spent a good deal of time over the last year knocking these barriers down to make sure that we can get people into housing quickly, and that we can go from the streets into a housing situation faster. It took us months and months to do that. My team is telling me that we've finally gotten to the point where we've got that smoothed out, and now we're really pushing forward with getting people into housing.
This is so great, and I want to talk about the tagline of the program.
Sure.
Because the tagline is the smart way to do the right thing. I love that. Explain what that means to our viewers.
Well, I think when we look at any kind of a social issue in our community, we have to realize that there are less than optimal human outcomes. You know, people are dying on the streets.
Of course.
But there's also this great expense to the community that I was talking about earlier.
Mm-hmm.
And if we can take those costs that the community is currently paying for, whether it's for the fire department, the police department, visits to emergency rooms, uncompensated stays in hospitals, take those costs, and if we can take 30 cents on the dollar of those costs and put them towards a program where we can get an individual off the street, get them stabilized.
Save their life, really.
You're not going to get better if you have mental health issues or if you have substance abuse issues. You're not going to get better living on the street.
Absolutely
not. If we can get you into a situation where you are more stable and we can surround you with care, so to speak, and this is volunteers, this is church groups, this is health providers, this is lots of people, then things are going to get better.
And the taxpayers are saving their dollars by doing that.
Absolutely.
And that's really what we're looking for. And we also want to just share with our viewers some of the other issues that are topping your agenda right now so that people know what's really going on in the city and what people really need to put their minds to.
Well, right now we're talking about moving the city forward. On October 4th, we all have a choice at the ballot box, so to speak. We have a city election on October 4th.
Yes.
Well, we've got 12 bond questions. This is everything from public safety to libraries to senior centers to keeping our roads running. We have ABQ the plan, which is question 12, which talks about taking some of the tax dollars that we send into the city and not growing government with those, but putting those back in the form of $50 million worth of improvements in the form of some Paseo del Norte and I-25 improvements, and also a regional sports complex. So we've got a lot of good things for people to go out on October 4th and support, because cities either invest in themselves and move forward or they fall behind. And Albuquerque is such a wonderful place.
It's amazing.
We just want to make sure that we're taking good care of our city. We need to create jobs, and this is a great way to do that.
Yeah, and people need to exercise their right to make those decisions and help. Because you know what? If you vote, you have a say. And if you don't, what can you complain about?
And this year we have, I think, 46 or 49 voting sites around the city. It's not the way it used to be. You can
so
go and
convenient.
Vote anywhere you want in the city, whether it's close to your work, close to your child's school.
It's great.
Yeah.
Very convenient. It's convenient, so there's no excuses.
Absolutely.
And thank you so much for what you're doing with Albuquerque Heading Home. I think this is so fantastic and a wonderful issue that you're tackling.
We've
right
got
now.
A long way to go, but we've got a good start, I think.
Great start. Thank you so much, Mayor Barry. We appreciate you being here, and we appreciate all that you're doing for our city. And still ahead, we are talking to Super Bowl champ Ed McCaffrey about his effort to tackle homelessness as well. But first, here are the sounds of David Nail performing tomorrow night at Tingley Coliseum after the PRCA.
It's hard to find the perfect time to say something you know is gonna change everything. Living with the shame, it ain't nothing like